So it, at first glance, it's a little funny how it's structured, because I don't usually see that. But I'm just thinking to myself, and tell me if you think I might be right, is the reason why when the Gemara first asked individually on each item, kerem with oilalois and kama with challah, is because that's a much bigger tzara chumra. Oil, the fact that you have a restriction that every single time you grow, there's a chiv oilalois, or every single time you try to enjoy wheat, you have to take challah, that's a much bigger tzara chumra, so that's a much more compelling argument to say that that product should require a bracha rather than other products. The tzad mizbeach is not such a big chumra, so the Gemara only resorts to it once the Gemara needs to find another svara. I'm just throwing it out. I don't know if that's true. And it's not true anyway. I just thought it's a little bit unusual that the Gemara goes to a different chumra. V'ashinam izayis, so... We're trying to, just because you know you have to make a bracha on a grape, how do you know from there that you'd have to make a bracha on an orange?
Right. So there are other differences, because you're not eating, you're not making a bracha on the grape, you're making a bracha on the wine. We're talking about wine and challah, right?
Are we? Wine and we're talking about either the bayi pri eitz on the grape or the agafen on the wine. We're talking about the general concept of making a bracha before you consume. Yeah, but it's coming from the grape. Yeah. So Zog to Gemara. Yeah.
That's
right.
That's another difference between them.
One of the Mepharshim spoke out something to do with that. That there's human involvement in both wine. I saw that svara somewhere. I don't remember exactly where it was related, but I did see that somewhere. That's a good point. You see what David's saying is the uniqueness about wine and wheat is they're not purely from the Ribbono Shel Olam, they involve human involvement to process it. We have to make the wine from the grape, and we have to make flour from the wheat and bread. So there's another interesting that you're eating straight out of this.
That's why the bracha is different than bread and grapes.
So let's see what the Gemara says weiter. V'asi name zayis. You should also include an olive. The is beitzad mizbeach. You're right. I might not have a right that all other food items require a bracha, but at least the olive should be included, because the olive also oil is used in the mizbeach. Zok Gemara. Are you claiming that the reason why you make a bracha on the zayis is because it has this tzad mizbeach? Kerem. You don't have to come on to the svara that zayis has the same tzara chumra as bread and as wine, because it has a tzad mizbeach. Zayis is called a kerem, so it would fit. Even if you're going to limit the Kodesh Elul Hashem to Kerem, Zai should fit under the Kerem category. Dichsiv, Vayivar Migodesh Vat Kama Vat Kerem Zayis. This is one of the most famous terrorist activities that was done by Shimshon. What he did was, is he wanted to destroy the fields of the Pelishtim, so he took a whole row of foxes, he tied their tails together, and he put a torch in the knot, lit them up, so he literally created a long line of fire, and he sent the foxes running across the fields, so he literally burnt up acres and acres of the Pelishtim's fields. But when it's referring to the fields, it says, Migodesh vat kam vat kerem zayis. So you see that the word kerem is appropriate to be used for olive tree. Omar Papa, you're right, but nevertheless, kerem zayis ikri, kerem stamalo ikri. If you use the word kerem to apply to a zayis, you have to put in the second name, kerem zayis, because kerem by itself, which is what we're learning by Kodesh Elulim Hashem, only applies to one. But mikol makim kasha, mala tzara shabu shabahan, sheyesh, shekein yesh ben tzad mizbeach. So how would you know all other products require a bircha nehenin before? Ela di yolof lo meshivis haminim. We would learn the chiv bracha from shivis haminim. Ma shivis haminim, dover shenehenah. Just like all of the shivis haminim, you have enough of them, v'tom bracha, and you need a bracha. I've called Dovish and a Hanaton bracha. So to anything that you have a no from, we require a bracha. So Akimor, you don't have a rye from there either. Because Mal Shivas Haminin, Shekin Chayovin Bibikurim. All of the Shivas Haminim have a Chiv Bikurim, and maybe that's why they need the bracha. But how do you know that other Minim need a bracha as well? V'oid, ha tenich la'achrov. you might learn from Shivas Aminim that you make a bracha l'achra from v'chalta v'savata, but l'fan of minayin, how do you know that you have to make a bracha before you eat something? That's not fair. The asu b'kav v'chomer, the same kav v'chomer we discussed earlier, that Mati clarified, after he finished the apple, he makes the bracha. Kishu rav l'kolos again, when he has the apple in his hand and he's hungry, for sure he should make the bracha. Ulaman d'tani netarivai, and even if we learn netarivai, so we could say that the pasuk is referring to all peris. Ha'tenech kol dover netia. That pasuk still only applies to neta, which are things that grow from the ground that you plant. But the lav bar netia, how about fruit products that are not things that grow from the ground? Going basar, beitzim, dogim, minole. How do you know these items? These are al berchasam shahakoil. How do you know they have a chiv bracha? They're not included in the pasuk of Kodesh Hilulim Lashem. El asvaru, at the end of the day, you have to come on to a svara. Asur loy la'adam shehenim min ha'olam hazeh b'lay bracha. It's a svara that a person cannot have hana from olam hazeh without a bracha. And all the psukim are merely asmachtes, remozim, but the reason why the rabbanim were misakin that we make a bracha l'fanav is because that's what's appropriate. Tan rabban. Asur loy la'adam shehenim min ha'olam hazeh b'lay bracha. Moal, he was moil. My tekante, how do you fix that? So Gemara, yelech etzal chacham, go to a chacham. Frank Gemara, yelech etzal chacham, my avidle, exactly what is he going to do for you? You ate without a bracha. What is he supposed to do? Ha avidle yisura. El amarava, no, yelech etzal chacham meikara. You have to go, a person should always be learning so that he'll be informed. Ignorance is not an excuse. And v'ilamdenu brachos kidei shelo yavoi lidei me'ila, she shouldn't come to me'ila. Yeah, you can't fix it. If you eat without a bracha, you can't uneat.
That particular aver, you cannot
be. That's right. But in general, to avoid the avers of me'ila, you have to be prepared. That's right. Amar b'nam shmuel, kol nehenim adam zabalei bracha kilu nehenim mikotshe shemayim. Shenemar, Lashem Haaretz Umaloya. Everything belongs to Hashem, and you're having enough from it. Rav Levi Rami. Rav Levi got asked a steer in Psukim. It says Lashem Haaretz Umaloya, but there's another book that says Hashemayim Shemayim Lashem, Baaretz Nesan Levnei Adam. So we do have ownership. Before the bracha, everything belongs to Hashem, and if we benefit from it, it's stealing from Hashem. We're mal. But after the bracha, then it, Hashem is given to Hashem says for us the son of the Adam after we make the bracha. It says Lashem Arutzumlo, everything belongs to Hashem, and then it says for us the son of the Adam. So who does the land belong to? Does it belong to Hashem? It belongs to us.
So why would
we
have to bring down the
pasuk Hashemayim
Shemayim
Hashem? Oh, because that's the son of the Adam. That's right. Amar Chanina by Papa. Kol Anehenim Adam Zebulei Bracha. Kilu goyzel HaKadosh Baruch Hu uKnesses Yisrael. It's like he's stealing not only from the Ribbono Shel Olam, but also from Knesses Yisrael. Why from Knesses Yisrael? So let's see in a minute. Shenemar goyzel ovev ve'imoy. He steals from his father and his mother. Ve'omer ein pasha. And he says, I didn't do anything wrong. Chaver hu le'ish mashkes. He's a friend, he's a partner to a destroyer. And the Gemara dashes the pasuk, ve'in ovev el HaKadosh Baruch Hu. So gozel ovev means stealing from HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Shenemar halehu avicha kanecha, which is in Hazinu. Vein imoy el HaKnesses Yisrael. And when it says aim in the pasuk, it's referring to Knesses Yisrael. Shenemar shema b'ni musar avicha valtitash teres imecha. So what does the end of the pasuk say? Chavar hu li'ish mashkes. My chavar hu li'ish mashkes. Amar chanina bar papa. Chavar hu li'yerovim benevot. He's a chaver to Yeruvim ben Nevat. Shehishchis es Yisrael lavim shemashemayim. He destroyed the relationship between Klal Yisrael and Ribbono Shel Olam. Rashi says shechata vehichti es Yisrael kachu chayte umachti. This person is a chayte umachti because if he eats without a bracha, people are going to learn from him, and they're not going to eat with a bracha, and that's going to destroy the relationship. And that's why it's ki'ilu geizel knesses Yisrael. Because not only are you stealing from HaKadosh Baruch Hu, you're also causing harm to Knesset Yisrael because you're going to influence others not to make a bracha, and that's going to cause problems. because it's the Torah that's passed down from generation to generation. That, I mean, that's how I understood it. I don't know if that's pshat. That's how I understood it. Reb Chanina bar Papa Rami. Reb Chanina bar Papa had a kasha. Ksiv says in the pasuk, "V'lakachti degani beitai." So let's have a look at the pasuk. It says, "Lachen Ashev." This is talking about people, I guess, when Klai Yisrael is doing averis. "Lachen Ashev." I'm going to go. "V'lakachti degani beitai." I'm going to take away the v'nesati degani beitai. I'm taking that away. "V'tiroshi b'mayado." I'm taking that away too. "V'tzalti tami u'fishi l'chaser v'as." I'm going to pull away all your benefits. So the problem is, it says v'lakachta degani, which means Hashem is saying it's my dagon, but in the Krishna it says v'safta degonecha, it's your dagon. Whose dagon is it? Lo'kashe kan bizman she Yisrael oisim retoinu shel makom, then it's ours. Kan bizman she ein Yisrael oisim retoinu shel makom, then it's not ours, and that's why Hashem says it's degani. Zokta more about the Tanur Rabban, v'safta degonecha. It says in Krishna you could gather your dagon. This is a beautiful Gemara. Ma tamed loymer? What's the pasuk trying to teach us? Lefish nemer, it says lo yomish sefer hatayr azemi picha. It says you should never stop learning. Well, never stop learning means ma'ais leis. You're learning 24/7, 365. Yachol dvarim kiksavim. You might think that you have to learn and you're never allowed to be mafsik from learning. Tamed loymer v'asafta deganecha. You have to work for a living. You have to gather in your dagon. Hanig bahen minig derecheretz. You have to fridge with the minig derecheretz. And you have to Rashi says Shem Tovoi Lidei Tzoyer Chabriyos Soivich Livatel Medivit Torah. If you're not going to be Isaac and Parnasa, you're going to end up relying on people. And if you rely on people, it's going to come to Bittel Torah. Divrei Rabbi Shmuel. So you see right away, there's no problem with relying on people. The problem is, it's going to come to Bittel Torah. If you don't have a job, you're going to have to go collecting, and that's Bittel Torah. Rabbi Shimon ben Yochi Omer, and we're going to discuss it soon. Rabbi Shimon ben Yochi Omer, Efshir. So we learned a Gemara very, very short time ago. We learned a Gemara about the Chassidim or Yeshayim had to spend a lot of time preparing for davening. And the Gemara asked at the time, if they're so busy concentrating on their davening, when are they going to get any learning done? So I think the Gemara was over here. The Gemara asked Torah Mata, what the Lashna Gemara was, I spoke it out then. Let me see if I can find it. Where it says a person has to. Does anybody know where that Gemara was? Is that the Chassidim Rishonim would spend time focusing, and the Gemara asked if they spend 3 hours davening each tefillah, when are they ever going to learn? I think it was on Lamed Aleph. I think it was. Okay, 1 second. Yeah, we just learned this. 1 second. Oh, here it is. It's on Lamed Beis Amud Beis. So it says Chassidim Rishonim Rishonim Shachas Umespalon Shachas VeChoyzim Rishonim Shachas VeChime Achas Rishonim Teishas Shoyas BeYoyim BeTfila. 3 hours per tefila times 3 tefilas a day is 9 hours. Toyroson Heich Mishtameres. Umalachton heich nasis. Elamitoich shechasidim heim, teirasa mishtemeris, umalachta misparechas. So now we have a this Gemara, which is similar but different. So let's see what the Gemara says over here. Rabbi Shimon ben Yochi Omer, you Rabbi Shimon say people have to work for a living. Well, efshir odom chorish b'shas charisha, v'zereya b'shas ria, v'koitzer b'shas katsira, v'dosh b'shas disha, v'zor b'shas haruach. If he's so busy all the time, there's always a season for something. You're always working. Torah matahayolel. So the Gemara here doesn't ask Torah heich mishtameres. It asks Torah matahayolel. Ela bizman shi Yisrael oisin b'tzenu shel mokayim malachta nasa yidecherim. If they're doing b'tzenu shel mokayim, they won't have to work. They'll have other people doing work for them. Shenemar v'omdu zorim, strangers will come u'tzaynchem, and they will take care of your sheep. Then they're going to have to do their own work. But it's worse. Not only will you have to do your own work, so So we have a lot of issues we have to deal with over here. First of all, like I spoke out a couple of days ago from Avgurvitz, there it says Taras Nehech Mishtamerish, because it's already talking about Chassidim or Rishonim who learn a lot. Here we're talking about Balabatim who don't have to learn, they're busy working. So that's why he asks Torah Matahei Olel. What'll be not Hech Mishtamerish? Where will they even learn? There the question is, how will they remember? How will they chazer? But the big kasha is Tosfos kasha. I don't understand. I don't understand something. So it's telling me that Vosavta de Ganecha is referring to people who are not doing Return of Shemokim. But the problem is it says, V'hoyim Shemoyah Tishmuel Mutzvosai. There's Vosavta de Ganecha. So that's very, very strange. So look at the Tosfos. And the Gemara also says that Vosavta de Ganecha is Vosman She'inosh Return of Shemokim. And there it says, a minute ago we learned that Vlakhti the Ganibi Itoi, that's Ain Mishan Shomakim. But by the Vasavta the Ganech is referring to Aisha Mishan Shomakim. So Toys asked the Kash from Taimar, Volakamon, Bizman Shain Yisrael Aisha Mishan Shomakim Kminale. The Yesh Lamizak Toys, there's different levels of Aisha Mishan Shomakim. The Mari Vadaish Aisha Mishan Shomakim. In Aisha Mishan Kolkach, the Enam Tzadikim Gemurim. So if you're doing a little bit Return of Shomakim, you'll have Pranosh, you'll have to work for it. But if you're mamash aporish and you're totally in learning, then you won't even have to do your own work. So that's the first pshat. The second pshat says that there's a machlokes and sugyas. I like the first pshat better. So I want to get into that. I just want to finish to the two dots that Rabbi Elvin spoke at some very interesting things. So, but this is the punchline. Amr Abaye, harba also krebi shmoel also biyotin. Many people worked when they were supposed to work, then they learned when they were supposed to learn. Tayrim their hearts, and it went well for them. But Kirb Shim ben Yochi, people did like Kirb Shim ben Yochi, but they also be yotin. And they didn't have pranosa, so they didn't work. Because they didn't work. Amalei Rabba l'Rabbanon, and Rabba told his Talmidim, b'matusim inaychu b'yom initzom v'yom itishrei, when the seasons arrive, where you have to plant, and you have to harvest, and you have to be busy, loistus chazukamo, don't come to yeshiva. Work, when you're supposed to work, work. But don't come to learn by me. Don't show yourself to me. In other words, stay home and do the work you have to do. Because if you don't work in the season, when you're supposed to work, then you're going to have trouble all year long, and then you'll never be able to learn properly. So there's a stira in Rambams. One Rambam says that you have to do Torah Be'er-Cheretz. The other Rambam says that anybody who wants could be like Shevet Levi, and he could learn, and he doesn't have to worry about Parnassah. So the shaila is how do you justify the two? So he explains a whole bunch of different sforas. So first of all, he said over from Reb Chaim Volozhin that if you're called Kulei Torah, yeah, then you can say that I could cut myself off from the Chiyuvei Parnasa. But most people don't qualify. But Reb Moshe Feinstein says those people who do qualify and who know they qualify, you're not allowed to say, listen, I know I qualify, I know I could be learning Yom V'Laila, but I don't want to have to come on to people. I don't want to do it. So Dr. Moshe, you're not allowed to. You have to. If you know that you could be someone who's Kulei Torah, you have to retreat from working, and you have to be Seim HaLabrius. Here's where Hanova can come in the wrong way. But that's what Moshe says, a Psak Halacha. Yep. Most people aren't on that Madrega. Another interesting thing, he spoke out from the Chasam Sofer.
Saying that they're Kulei Torah,
yeah,
or saying I don't want to come on to people.
He says a nice thing over. He says, "What does it mean? If you're doing it because you want to learn Be'etzim, yeah, then it'll work for you. But if you're doing it just to be a copycat of Reb Shimon Yochi, then it doesn't work. So, Reb Shimon Yochi will also be yotin because they didn't do it l'shem shemayim. They did it because they just wanted to be like him. They tried to duplicate him. Although, I mean, what's wrong with trying to duplicate a tzaddik? I don't know." But those are the different svaris on there. Amar Rabba Bar Chana Amar Rechon Meshur Meb Yehuda Bar Eloi Bar A. Come take a look. Shaloi Kedoris Rishonim Doris Achoinim. The current Doris are unlike the Frida Kedoris. Doris Rishonim Azu Taras and Kva Umalach Tanari. Their focus was on Torah and the Malach was Agavarcha. And you know what happened? Zuv Zuv and Skabi Yodin. They were successful in both arenas. Doris Achoinim Shalos Umalach and Kva. They focus more on their working. The Taras and Arai and their Torah they just fit in when they could. Zuvazul and Iskaim Biyadin, they're not successful in either arena. Vama Rabba Babachanam Rabbiachanam, Mishra Mabiyuda Barloi, Bore, come and see Shalika Doris, Rishayim Doris Achorinim. Our Doris are not so good like the previous Doris. Doris Rishayim Hayimachnisim Periseim Derech Teraximine, they brought their Paris into their homes through the main gate. Because we know that you're only Chayiv and Meiser with the Raisa if you bring it in through the main gate. Kedela Chayiv and Meiser, they wanted to be Machayiv and Meiser. There's a chroinim, machlizim perzem, der gagos, der chatzers, der chavivos, kadil apotrim in a miser. Damar Biyani, Biyani said, ain't a tevel mischaib a miser, achi yirah pnei abayis, nemar bi'arti akadish min abayis. Rabbi Yochanan, mar filu chotzer kabas, even the chotzer is mischaib in trumas a miser, shenemar v'ochlu b'shurecha v'saveyu. So Rabbi Elvin spoke out that don't look so down on the duris that they try to get around the loophole of giving maaser. That's not what it was. There was a machloikis, what's greater, a mitzvah v'oisa or any mitzvah v'oisa? And the Doris HaKadosh held that any mitzvah v'oisa was a better madrega. So they still took the maasers, but they wanted it to be with the madrega of any mitzvah v'oisa. Chutz min hayayin, maas no yayin, what's so special about wine that it gets its own bracha? Ilema mishum de ishtin le'iluya, since it became better, so therefore ishtin le'bracha.
Why did it knock down the Doris HaKadosh? What they did was because they held mitzvah and a mitzvah voice.
Who's that? Not, no, who's that? This last point is knocking them down.
There was.
Oh, I guess because we're wrong.
What to say? No mitzvah.
Yeah, but at the end of the day, the Gemara says mitzvah voice is better. The Gemara can get more schaffer than mitzvah voice.
We are mitzvah voice.
Yeah, it's a Gemara someone that discusses that mitzvah voice is better. Right? To someone who's blind, he says, I could be kind of mitzvah, I'm any mitzvah voice.
Right.
If it's because wine is an upgrade from grapes, ishtani lebracha. Well, a very shemen ishtani liluya. Shemen also is an upgrade over the olive. V'lo ishtani lebracha, and we still make the same bracha. So what are you supposed to say? Boyer priya zayis. Heichin nevarach. Nevarach boyer priya zayis. Peregufa zayis yirkri. When you say bar priya gofen, the word gofen is referring to the vine. The priya gofen is referring to something that came from the wine. But zayis doesn't only refer to the tree, but it refers to the fruit itself. So you can't make a bracha bar priya zayis because you're eating the zayis itself. Right? If the zayis means only the tree, so the priya zayis is a fruit of the tree. But zayis means the olive itself. So zokt mar zayis gufe, Nevarach by pri zayis, per gufei zayis yikri. So zok tamar, so v'nevarach lei by your pri, eight zayis. Make a bracha, by your pri, eight zayis. By your pri, the pri of an olive tree. Alamar zutra, chamer zayin, mishkale zayin. Chamer satisfies, oil doesn't satisfy. V'ekne mor v'atnan, hanoidim in ha-mozoin, muta b'mayim u'melach. If you make a nether, I'm not going to have mozoin. You're allowed to drink only water and salt. And not oil. Everything is called mozoin. Name it to the Rabbi Shmuel. It should be an obstruct to Rabbi Shmuel. The Amri ain mevarch and boyer minim mezoinos. Because mozoin is only hay minim. For Amarvuna over there, it's ba'omer kol hazon alai. The reason why oil was also there is because you said kol hazon alai. So when you see from there alma mishchazayin, you see that when you drink oil, it does nourish you. It might not be called mozoin, but it's amazing somebody, and therefore it should require a bracha. So, tomorrow, el chamer soid, chamer satisfies you, satiates you. Umishcha loy soid. So there's zayin, which gives you sustenance. There's soid means to satisfy you, which is even more. Fek more, v'chamer mi soid, does wine really satisfy you? For Rav Avishoshi chamer, kol maili yoyim de pisro, he would drink wine every Erev Pesach, kehechi de nigri lalibe, v'nechol matzah tvei, fakert. Fakert, you see that it makes you hungry. So tomorrow, it depends how much you drink. Tuva gar, a lot of wine will make you hungry, but porta, a little bit of wine, sud makes you satisfied.
Why did he drink wine?
Because he wanted to build up his appetite, so he'll eat matzah with more gusto. And the Mefarshim speak out that he wasn't drunk, that you want to, he should eat more matzah. He's going to eat the same shir, but he'll eat it with greater geshmak, and that was part of the mitzvah. In fact, no misot cloud, do you have any hana, any satiation from wine at all? Vaksiv, yiviyayin, yisamach. We gotta stop. We have to stop. So we'll stop over here. We'll be mamshich here on Friday. We'll meet him next week. Next Shabbos. Next week, starting Sunday, I'm not gonna be here for almost 2 weeks. So.